Thank you so much, President Petro Poroshenko, and thank you for very useful and very constructive discussions, both yesterday and today. And also thank you for inviting me to the National Security and Defense Council of Ukraine. It has been a real pleasure to meet with them and to discuss the challenges we face together at the meeting today. This is my first visit to Ukraine as Secretary General of NATO, and I would like to start by commending you, President, for your strong leadership in very challenging times for both Ukraine and for NATO, and we appreciate what you do, and you should know that you have the strong support of the whole alliance in your efforts to find a political solution and to counter the aggressive actions of Russia against your country. We also very much appreciate the partnership and the excellent cooperation between Ukraine and NATO. And we have developed this partnership over almost 20 years. And you are a highly valued partner, and Ukraine contributes to our alliance. Your troops have served together with NATO troops in Afghanistan and in Kosovo. Ukrainian ships have fought piracy in the Indian Ocean together with NATO ships. And Ukrainian troops have participated in the NATO Response Force. And all of this really underlines and highlights that Ukraine is contributing to the alliance, and we thank you for your many different contributions. So NATO can rely on Ukraine, and Ukraine can rely on NATO. Our partnership is already very strong, and today we took steps to strengthen our partnership even further. NATO will continue to support Ukraine on its reform path. Our five trust funds make a real contribution in areas like command and control, cyber defense, logistics, and medical rehabilitation. We also provide advisors to the Ministry of Defense and to your general staff. All of this is important to modernize, to reform your armed forces, and this is important for Ukraine, but it's also a part of developing our partnership, our ability to work together, our interoperability. In addition to what NATO does, several NATO allies provide support for Ukraine in different ways. Allies are supporting your country in by providing training and equipment and humanitarian aid. And as we also discussed during the meeting, we met some of these soldiers yesterday. We actually had dinner with them, the Canadian soldiers and the soldiers from the United States. And I think this is a very concrete expression of that NATO and NATO allies support Ukraine in many different ways. We will enhance our defense technical cooperation so our forces can work even closer together. This will help modernize your defense industry and open up new possibilities for even more cooperation between NATO, NATO allies, and Ukraine. We have also signed an agreement on the status of the NATO offices in Kiev and another agreement on to boost Ukraine's government communication capabilities. Strategic communication is important, and we would very much appreciate to be able to work even closer together with you in developing your capabilities on strategic communication. Mr. President, we have discussed the security situation in eastern Ukraine. NATO stands firm in our support for Ukraine's sovereignty and territorial integrity. Russia's illegal and illegitimate annexation of Crimea and its military actions in eastern Ukraine are a serious challenge to Ukraine, but also to the security of Europe. The Minsk agreement remains the only way out of the crisis and to restore Ukrainian sovereign control over its own borders. NATO fully supports the efforts within the Trilateral Contact Group and the Normandy format to find a political solution. I welcome the renewed effort to fully implement the Minsk agreements. The ceasefire is mainly holding. This is encouraging, but the situation remains fragile. Russia continues to support the separatists, not only politically, but also militarily. This must stop. Heavy weapons have to be removed from the contact line, and OSCE monitors must have full access so they can do their job. You, President Poroshenko, and the Ukrainian government have taken bold steps towards constitutional changes for more decentralization and for more self-governance. These are difficult political decisions, but they show Ukraine's commitment to find a peaceful solution. A secure, prosperous, and independent Ukraine is in everyone's interest. So thank you once again for excellent meetings, discussions, and for hosting me and my delegation here in Kyiv. Thank you. Thank you.